All right. For first 15-20 minutes, I'll be discussing cyber safety. Then I'll be switching over to the revision of Impress. Okay. So yesterday we were doing private browsing, and I told you that when we are doing private browsing, our personal information, our IP address, our history doesn't get created. Our information is not going to the third party. Okay, clear? So we are under safe environment. And types of private browsing is incognito, proxy, and VPN. VPN is virtual private network. Incognito browsing, as I told you yesterday, that when we click on those four dots and we click on the new incognito window, we switch over to the incognito browsing. The history is not created. Our IP address, our location, our information is not shared with the third party, right? So our environment is fully secure. Okay? No, our personal information is being delivered to the third party. And what is proxy? Proxy acts as a middleman. I am accessing one website. When I am accessing the website, my IP address, my location, my information will be shared by the third party. It will be going to that website. Okay. Now, proxy acts as a middleman. Okay. When the tracking website will try to track my IP address, they will track the IP address of proxy. वो प्रॉक्सी का आईपी एड्रेस वहां जाएगा, मेरा नहीं जाएगा. ओके, बट दे विल हैव दिस इल्यूजन दैट इट इज माइन. सो अगेन आई एम अंडर सिक्योर एनवायरनमेंट, राइट? देन वीपीएन. व्हाट इज वीपीएन? वर्चुअल प्राइवेट नेटवर्क. वेदर यू आर इन द पब्लिक नेटवर्क और वेदर यू आर इन द प्राइवेट नेटवर्क, फुल सिक्योरिटी इज प्रोवाइडेड by virtual private network. Okay, so that no hacker or no unauthorized user should try to crack your or hack your personal details. Clear? Okay, now comes the topic of password. Okay, generally you are using computer at home, you are using smartphones also, you are very much familiar with the technology these days. In general mean general meaning in general real life meaning, what is password? How you define password? Raise your hand. In your knowledge, what is password? Any word that saves our data. Okay. Password is known to people. You can share your passwords. Means you can share your password. Your voice is not audible to me. Could you please speak louder? Secure our account. Okay. A special code, a special word, okay, collection of characters, okay, that protects our personal details from the outside world. It acts as a lock, okay, and hides our details. Why we lock our house? To safeguard our house. So that no unauthorized person should enter our house and steal our material. Similarly, we put a lock onto our account so that no unauthorized person should enter our account and hack our details. That is the use of password. And password shall never be shared with anyone. If we are sharing our password, we are prone to risk. You never know when anyone will hack your ID and will misuse your ID. From your ID, the attacker can send fake messages to any other third person. So you will be under trouble. You will be the culprit. Okay. So password is a very important form of protection. It safeguards our personal details. It provides us fully secure environment. Right? Now, how to choose a good password? This question has come a lot many times in the exams. Suggest some points for choosing the good password. Kwaish, please focus here. Switch off your PC. Do not keep any dictionary words, any nouns, or any foreign words as password. Do not keep any personal information as a password, like your phone number, your date of birth, your vehicle number, like someone put Activa number as a password. Such things can be easily cracked. Okay. Use longer password. Your password should be long, long sequence of characters, including uppercase, lowercase, special characters also. Clear? Then use paraphrases to remember long passwords. If you have a longer password, so use paraphrases around it. Okay. Do not repeat password on different websites. You have account on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Do not keep same password on all the websites. If your password is same, if one account is cracked, other will also be hacked. Right? Now comes another important concept similar to privacy: confidentiality of information. Okay, now again, I have a question from you all. What is confidential? This talk is confidential. What do you mean by this? Yes, Gurupal. Secret. Very right. Very good. The very simple meaning Gurupal has given and a very clear meaning he has given. Secret. Very good. Any other? Hidden. Keep our conversation confidential. Ki hamari baat kisi third person tak na jaye. Hamari baat hamare tak hi rahe. Hum dono ke beech mein rahe. It should be between two parties, A and B, sender and receiver. Yeah, suppose our property papers. Your parents keep property papers inside the locker, inside the bank locker. Bank provides the locker facility. At home, if they have locker, they keep important documents in that locker. They don't share that information with any third person. Even they don't share with you sometimes, because that is confidential. Your RC of Activa or your conveyance is confidential document. Your result sheet is confidential. You can't disclose it publicly. Your passwords are confidential. Okay, clear? Your account details are confidential. What transactions you are doing, you cannot share with anyone. So confidential means keeping some things secret, hidden. You can say directly or indirectly private. It is in correlation to privacy. Some people announce privacy as privacy. Some pronounce it as privacy. Both ways are correct. Privacy or privacy. Dharya, be alert. So what is confidentiality? Only authorized users get the access to sensitive and protected data. You can share your confidential information only with the authorized person. Suppose you are having any problem. You will discuss, you will share problem with your parents only, not to your neighbors. You can share your problem with your parents, because they are authorized persons. You cannot go and share with your neighbors and in the whole colony that I have this problem. Right? Then how to ensure confidentiality? How can you be sure that confidentiality is maintained? Use firewall wherever possible. Firewall can be hardware, can be software. It acts as a barrier that prevents any entry of unauthorized persons. कोई भी unauthorized person आपके network में enter नहीं कर सकता once you have installed firewall. It will block. Okay? Like suppose some unknown person is sending you messages on WhatsApp. You can block that person. Blocking means you are preventing any wrong entry by that person. You are restricting that person from sending you any message. That is firewall. Control the browser settings. Browse privately. Just I told you, do the private browsing. Be careful while posting anything on internet. Yesterday also I told you, when you are posting something on internet, be careful what you are posting. Any wrong thing posted by you can put you in big trouble, right? Ensure safe sites by checking that URL contain HTTPS, Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. Okay? Carefully handle emails. When you open any email, suppose your friend has sent you email along with some attachment, do not at once click on attachment. First scan it. Okay, before opening and using it, scan it. It may contain virus. Okay, and never open any unknown emails. Never open any unknown emails means any email which is sent by any unauthorized person to you. You are not aware about that person and that person has sent you email. Do not open that. Do not click on any unknown link. Some person send you the link in your WhatsApp group that click on the link and so you will win this much lottery and this much, you will have this much award. Okay, so don't click on any unknown links, right? Avoid using public computers. Do not give sensitive information on networks. Do not. अच्छा कई बार क्या होता है जैसे आप देखा होगा when you visit cyber cafe, some persons when they are working on when they are accessing the internet, they get up and they walk off without doing any logout, without signing out from the account. A person is there who is accessing the internet and he has opened his Gmail account. Suddenly he got up and he moved for some urgent work, leaving the account open. He didn't sign out. Is he safe? Is account safe? Not at all. Any third person, any wrong person can misuse that ID. He can send any wrong email to anyone. And who will be under trouble? The original creator of the ID, the original owner of the ID. So whenever you are under your account, you are doing your work. After doing your work, sign out, log out. Okay. Whether you suppose you are accessing Instagram, once you accessed, log out. Okay. Clear? Okay. Next is malware. Malware in simple terms, one word, malicious software. Any software having wrong intent that cause damage to your system, that can cause damage to your files, that can disturb the normal functioning of computer system. That comes under malware, which bring your system into adverse effects. Right, which disturbs the normal working of your computer, like virus, worm, Trojan horse. Okay, ninth class, I'm revising IMPRESS topics now. Okay, I'll be continuing with the cyber safety in the next lecture. Now, this is the first window we come across when we open OpenOffice IMPRESS. This is first step of presentation wizard. Be careful. Okay. Now in the first step, what we have empty presentation option from template, open existing presentation. Here we select what type of presentation we are to create. Empty means we are to create presentation from scratch, from the very root side. Okay, from template means template are the predefined designs, right? Open existing presentation. Open existing presentation means we have already created some presentation. We are to open it. Might be we want to make some changes, right? Then we click on the next and we enter the step two. In step two, we set the background of our presentation, right? Like it has two options, presentations and presentation backgrounds. These are the presentation backgrounds. You can select any background and the preview of it you will see here, right? Suppose I am activating this option, blue step gradients. Then we set what output medium we want. I want screen. Screen is by default activate. I click on next. In the third step, I set the transition effects, the visual effect I want to give to my slide, right? Whatever effect you will select, the preview of the effect you will notice in the preview window, and click on the create button and it will start your OpenOffice Impress. You will see the window of OpenOffice Impress with all the settings that you have previously done. Suppose you don't want to do any settings in the presentation wizard, you can directly click on the create button in the first time only. You don't want to make any settings prior. As step one of wizard opens, directly click on the create button. You will come here in the window with the white workspace. You can make settings here also. You can make all settings here also. Right now in front of you, the view that is open is the default view, normal view. Normal view is the default view. Impress mein views hote hain. Ye dekho kaun kaun se views hain. Normal, outlining view, notes view, handout view, slide sorter view. Normal view is the by default view. In normal view, you see the normal Impress window with the three panes. PANES, slide pane, workspace, task pane. This is task pane. All these three panes are visible in normal view. Okay, let us shift to outline view. In outline view, we see the outlining of the slides. Just I give one live example to you. After the chapter is finished in the book, you have things to remember or points to remember. What is points to remember? The summary of the chapter. So here you just see the outlining, just the text, main text and the subtext, right? Notes view or speaker notes or notes view. In this, we can add some extra notes if we want after our slide. Like when I send e-notes to you, many times I write note to give you some extra information about it. Similar to that only. Handout view. Handout view is the compressed version of the slide. You know what is thumbnail? I show you thumbnails. Wait. Suppose I have opened this. Okay, and view. Small icons. These are thumbnails. Small window, small miniature view. Small miniature view of your slide. Right now you can see six slides are in the thumbnail view on one page. Slide ko compressed karke humne page pe adjust kiya. Okay, and slide sorter view. Slide sorter view means whatever presentation you are having, all the slides will appear in thumbnail view. more clearly if you want to see, I open PowerPoint here. And I show you the clear, okay, I open this cyber ethics PPT. Just example I'm showing you, okay? View, slide sorter. See, these are the slides which I have created, total 16 slides, and they are appearing as thumbnail. Slide 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can adjust how many slides you want in one row. That you can make settings. You can adjust. You can change the order of the slides here. Like I want my third slide to become sixth slide. You can change the order. Third becomes sixth. Sixth becomes third. Reordering of the slides can be easily done. You can hide the slide by right clicking and hide. When the slide is hidden, it won't appear in the slideshow. Just today, you have seen when I started the lecture of cyber safety, the previous slides didn't appear in the slideshow. Directly, I start from the relevant slide. So you can hide. Hide doesn't mean it get deleted. It is temporary hidden. You don't want to show in the slideshow. You kept it hidden. If you want to unhide it, again click on hide slide. It becomes activate. Temporary disable, then enable. You can delete any slide if you want. Right? Clear what is slide sorter view? नॉर्मल व्यू में भी हो सकती है हाइड. ये देखो यहां पे भी हो सकती है हाइड. स्लाइड कैन बी हिडन इन नॉर्मल व्यू एज वेल एज इन स्लाइड सॉर्टर व्यू. यहां देखो होगी हाइड. इसके नंबर पे क्रॉस आ गया. देखो फोर्थ नंबर स्लाइड मैंने हाइड की है एंड नंबर फोर्थ हैज बीन डिसेबल. ओके नाउ द क्वेश्चन कम्स हाउ टू इंसर्ट न्यू स्लाइड. देर आर सो मेनी मेथड्स. राइट नाउ देर इज फर्स्ट स्लाइड. I want to insert one more slide. First method, click on insert menu, choose the slide option. First method, second method. This is presentation toolbar. Can you see it? Presentation toolbar has following buttons: slide view, a slide button, slide layout, slide design, duplicate slide, expand slide, slideshow. This is presentation toolbar and it is only available in Impress in any presentation software. This toolbar will not be available in your Word and Excel. Now here you can click on the slide button and the slide can be inserted. Okay. See. Clear second method. Third method to insert slide. Right click on the slide pane. Right click on the slide in the slide pane. This is slide pane. This is workspace. This is task pane. Right click on the slide in the slide pane. Click on new slide option. Slide can be inserted. Fourth method. Right click on the slide in the workspace. Click on slide button. Then click on new slide button. See, slide got inserted. Got it? Okay, what this is layout, slide layout. Slide layout is available in format menu or under properties section of task pane. Task pane ke andar properties section hai. Properties section ke andar aapko total 12 layouts dikhenge. Total 12 layouts. And this is also available in presentation toolbar. The slide layout button is also available in presentation toolbar. What is slide layout? The physical structure of the slide. Okay, clear?